The iPhone 7 Plus was released 4 years ago on September 16, 2016 along with the iPhone 7, which I made a review of last year and this year. It was one of the most controversial iPhones, if not the most, in the market. It is because of the removal of the headphone jack, but how does it hold up in 2021? What's up guys, welcome or welcome back to my YouTube channel, I'm Eze Coson. For today's topic, we are going to discuss, is the iPhone 7 Plus still worth buying in 2021? But before we start, roll intro. The iPhone 7 Plus has a glass front, wherein the back and the frame are from aluminum. It has an IP67 dust and water resistance up to 1 meter for 30 minutes. Despite that factor, keep in mind, it is water resistant and not waterproof. It came with a variety of colors, namely silver, gold, rose gold, red edition, matte, and jet black. Let us now discuss the parts. On the side, we have a power button and the SIM slot. On the other side, we have volume buttons and a ringer switch. Below, we have two speakers and a lightning port. And this was the first iPhone to have no headphone jack, which was a major controversy back when it was released. Many tech enthusiasts and reviewers, as well as tech consumers, was puzzled because of the sudden disappearance. Despite that, it paved way for the Apple AirPods anyways. Moving on, at the back, we have a dual camera sensor, which was the first iPhone to have this kind of lens setup, which we'll discuss on the camera department later. On the front, we have a gigantic 5.5-inch screen display, which we'll discuss as well later. Below that is a force-sensitive static button instead of the mechanical clicky one that we can find from the predecessors. Has a second-gen fingerprint sensor similar to the iPhone 6s and 6s Plus, and it works amazingly great. It is very responsive and really reliable and trustworthy in terms of security and speed usability. Design-wise, it still is classy and not outdated looking, despite it being a 4-year-old iPhone and having Apple's conventional design. However, being a phone that has an aluminum build, expect to have paint chips caused by scratches, so make sure to install a case. Although, if you have the jet black variant, a protective layer, tempered glass, and a case is highly recommendable, since the shiny surface is prone to micro abrasions which may result to tiny scratches and may have a shattered glass when dropped. 7 Plus features a Full HD Retina display and a max brightness of 625 nits. It has a screen size of 5.5 inches with a 67.7% screen to body ratio. It has a screen resolution of 1080 by 1920 pixels and a pixel density of 401. The iPhone 7 Plus has a 3D touch sensor, which is faster than the haptic touch used by most flagship successors. Of the screen size, it is still relatively big in comparison with their current phones. However, we can somehow see that it aged well since the current trend are all screen or full screen phones, but by any means, it is not outdated size-wise. I just currently experience some minor problems being a person who is used to notch iPhones as a daily driver. But after a few weeks of using this phone, I got used to it anyways, considering the fact that I have been a traditional design iPhone user. Talking about the screen resolution, it is still a banger. It can and will still impress you if you're planning to upgrade or degrade from a flagship. Although, placing a flagship successor over the iPhone 7 Plus, we may see some differences display-wise, but it is not that much to worry about. So in conclusion, size and display-wise, it is still relevant. The iPhone 7 Plus started from iOS 10, then upgradable to the latest software. It is powered by an Apple A10 Fusion chip, which has quad-core CPU and 6-core graphics. It packs 3GB of RAM, and the storage variants are 32, 128, and 256GB. Performance in general, in terms of opening apps or having a lot of apps in the background, we can really perceive and experience the A10 Fusion chip is really pushing the boundary speed-wise. When I scroll my homepage and launching apps, there are hardly any hiccups or stuttering. It is very fluid, I should say. However, being a 4-year-old iPhone, it also tends to buffer quite a bit, and this is normal. Gaming-wise, it is still somehow recommendable. The games that we usually play are still playable. The processor is still great in powering the device. However, I sometimes experience the byproduct of the phone's age. In other words, it tends to have frame drops, and it overheats if you play intensively from extensive games. I believe it just has something to do with me being a little bit overconfident and complacent about the phone's capability, being a person who have used an iPhone 7 Plus a year ago. But yeah, overall, it is still a great phone, although don't set your standards too high on this phone. It still has reasonable lags and frame drops, but performance in general can still impress us. The iPhone 7 Plus has a dual camera setup. The first lens has 12 megapixels and an aperture of f/1.8. The second lens has 12 megapixels as well and an aperture of f/2.8, which is a telephoto lens used for portrait shots. The available video variants are 720p at 30fps, 1080p at 30 or 60fps, and 4K at 30fps. Photos generated are still phenomenal. It still really looks great on this 2016 iPhone. Its processing has been always good and reliable to begin with. At the time, it was revolutionary, and no smartphone can be as better or at least as good as the iPhone 7 Plus. Sharpness, clarity, you name it. But in the current generation, it somehow falls behind our current flagships, but it is not that far away, and again, it is still good overall. The camera of the iPhone 7 Plus has 7 megapixels and an aperture of f/2.2. It has a video resolution of 1080p at 30fps. The front camera is still great as well, I should say, especially with the use of natural outdoor lighting. So here are some shots to see it for yourself. So guys, this is the front camera quality of the iPhone 7 Plus. It has 8 megapixels and an aperture of f/2.2. It uses 1080p at 30fps. So guys, I also made an iPhone 7 Plus review last year, which to be honest, I'm not that satisfied with the video quality in general. So in this video, I hope that most of you will be impressed or will be satisfied. So I did my best here. So yeah. The iPhone 7 Plus has 2900 mAh. Battery quality is not that much of a mediocre, despite it not even reaching the standard 3000 mAh. It is not that ancient to say at least. Also, typical stereotype with Plus models is that they last longer than most non-Plus iPhone models. But this is theoretical and it doesn't hold true in most cases. It depends on the battery health beta and the type of battery it is using. It has a lithium ion which tends to degrade over time. Also, pro tip, never let your phone to drain or at least reach 20%. If it is below 25%, charge it instantly. But yeah, number wise, I can use the iPhone 7 Plus for 5 to 8 hours more or less in terms of basic usage. By the way guys, you can purchase an iPhone 7 Plus for as low as 9,000 pesos up to 12,000 pesos being the highest, which for that price is a great investment and trust me, it will satisfy all your needs and wants for a phone. So guys, if you are an iPhone 7 Plus user or you have used one, please comment below your experiences with it. Let's communicate and socialize and have a community. And help enlighten people planning to buy iPhones.
Okay.
And lastly guys, before I formally end this video, let's do some shoutouts.
Nice.
So first shoutout goes to Justin Ganal. So shoutout to you bro, stay safe. Next shoutout goes to John Rainier Gino. So shoutout to you bro, stay safe as well.
Okay.
Third shoutout goes to Mikey Cutie. So hindi naman talaga siya guys nagpapa-shoutout, it's just that she commented on one of my videos, bashing comment actually, and some of my viewers commented on her comment, parang pinagtanggol ako. So thank you to those viewers, but Mikey is one of the viewers na palabiro and I believe she doesn't mean it naman, so ayun. But again, thank you to those viewers na kahit pa paano pinagtanggol ako, so thank you for the support. Next shoutout goes to Kate Molina. So she commented on my iPhone 7 review. She was requesting me to review iPhone 6s Plus versus the iPhone 7, so sooner or later we'll make a review of that, so stay tuned.
Okay.
So next shoutout goes to Erica May Bruan. She has a YouTube channel, so please do subscribe to her channel, so ayun. And lastly guys, special shoutout or special mention to Gab Fortes and Kier Kriopta. So thank you very much for the undying support, because whenever I upload videos guys, they are the ones that really stand out or that always comments on my videos. So thank you very much for doing so. But don't get me wrong, I appreciate all of the viewers that watch my videos, like my videos, or comments on my videos, and subscribe to my YouTube channel. So yeah.
Nice.
So if you want a shout out guys, just comment below anything with the hashtag #EzekShoutouts. So guys, that's pretty much the end of the video. Thank you very much for watching. See you in the next video. Peace.